Right, I apologise profusely for the introduction to my last video. That was miscalculated and misguided, and probably the reason why it's got like the lowest views of any of my videos to date. So I apologise profusely for the bad impression of Jude Law and the very, very crude opening to my last video. This one is quite polite by comparison. The ShortTooth channel welcomes you to the review of Luc Besson's The Family. To do the review of this film, which kind of might tell you something about how I felt about it. Anyway, it's a bit forgettable. I only saw this yesterday and I'm forgetting it already, but I'm not going to criticize it totally. From the off, let me just say this: it's a 5 or a 6 out of 10 movie. It's middle of the road. It's not bad enough for me to hate it, and it's not decent enough for me to even say, yeah, it was pretty good. It's just middle of the road stuff. So let me give you a bit of background. Luc Besson, who's probably best known for directing Leon and The Fifth Element, has directed this movie, The Family, starring Robert De Niro and Michelle Pfeiffer. It's about a mafia man who enters into witness protection. He rats out on some of his previous colleagues, for want of a better word, and gets relocated to the south of France. But he and his family have had to move around from place to place because everywhere they go, they don't settle. They always cause problems, so they get moved on somewhere else. So he ends up in Normandy. And the film begins with him and Michelle Pfeiffer and their son and their daughter arriving at this sort of like rural house in Normandy, in small town Normandy. So already you've got the usual fish out of water scenarios and whatnot that are at play. And you've got Robert De Niro playing Robert De Niro, how he does these days, which is the comedic, well, not even comedic, the sort of, I'm going to be funny by being a bit bored in this situation, or by reacting by raising my eyebrows and stuff like that.
Just the prospect of packing up again and moving when they find out you killed the plumber.
I didn't kill him. I took him to the hospital.
Why'd you beat him to a pulp?
He's the only plumber within a radius of 20 miles.
But he disrespected us and he made you wait on him. Honey.
Jeez, honey, I survived.
And you know, the guy was trying to rip me off. So put yourself in my shoes.
Well, I definitely wouldn't have beat him up. I mean, who's going to fix the pipes now?
Well, who's going to rebuild the supermarket that burned down the day we got here? Huh?
And then there's a variety of situations. Basically, they have to then conform to rural French life. And to be honest with you, there's not a lot more to it than that. Obviously, you've got the compulsory mafia back home in America who want to know where they are, want to find out what's going on. Inevitably, we'll track them down by the end of the film, and there'll be a big confrontation at the end of which, obviously, De Niro and his family will survive because it's a 15-rated comedy. It's going to play by the numbers. So I'm not really spoiling anything by telling you that. So, yeah, I mean, it's pretty standard. It's traditional fare. It is what it is, what you expect it to be. It's no better and it's no worse. But what I will say for it, because I want to go a bit beyond just saying things like that, what I will say for it is there's a couple of things that really do work in its favour, which I was impressed by. Number one, you've got a teenage son and a teenage daughter that Robert De Niro and Michelle Pfeiffer play the parents of. And as soon as I saw this teenage son and daughter, I thought, right, here we go, the pain in the ass, teenage, stop saying teenage son and daughter, the pain in the ass kids of the family that are just going to be playing up to the usual teenage stereotypes that we've got, that both wisecracking and all of that shit. They'll be like American Pie rejects, far too witty for their age. But actually, it wasn't that bad. the son was actually quite funny at times, and he actually was quite switched on and smart. The daughter was quite ridiculous because she falls in love with her maths teacher, who, apart from being completely inappropriate because of the unexplained age difference, is just completely unbelievable. However, she wasn't the super uber bitch either. And what was more refreshing was the fact that they weren't pitted off against each other, the brother and sister. Normally in these sort of things, you know, the brother and sister are going at each other all the way through it. They weren't doing it in this. They were actually teaming up and working alongside each other throughout and going through things together, which was quite nice. They actually did come across as a fairly convincing family, actually. You could see the closeness.
What are you guys doing?
It is just 5 minutes to get to know each other better. Oops.
Hey boys, if this is your approach to women, you're not going to get very far.
So that was nice. The other nice thing about it is Robert De Niro's character. He's meant to be playing a low profile, you know, just pretending to be a typical American who's just moved to France. And he's convinced everyone that he's a writer. And what he's doing is he's writing his memoirs because he needs to purge himself of his past as a mafia man, because he can't let go of the fact that he was in the mafia. It's clear that he always wanted to be a gangster, and he still wants to be a gangster. And that's made even... Sorry about that, ran out of memory. So I think I was saying he's invited to this cinema screening of a film because he's meant to be a commentator on all things American. And the film inevitably turns out to be Goodfellas. There's quite this ironic spin of the fact that Robert De Niro was obviously in Goodfellas, and now he's playing a character who's being asked to commentate on Goodfellas to this French crowd. So it has some nice elements like that. But to be honest, I mean, I love De Niro, man. He's my favourite actor, and he is. Sometimes I think Al Pacino might be my favourite actor, but he's not. Robert De Niro is my favourite actor. I love that man, what he did, what he could do. His films of old were brilliant. You know, I've read his biography. I've owned almost every single film that he has. I've watched almost every single film that he has made. And in the last 10 years, as with a lot of people, it's just disappointment after disappointment. And unfortunately, we've got to resign ourselves, those of us who are fans of De Niro's work, to the fact that he ain't starring in the films that he used to star in. Obviously, he can't play the parts that he was playing before because he's 30, 40 years old. I understand that. But I don't understand why he has to be picking shit films and shit roles in shit comedies for the most part that are instantly forgettable. To be honest, the one thing that I heard he was good in recently, which I haven't seen, is Silver Lining Playbook. But even that, I mean, man, that's him doing a good performance in a supporting role. I want him in a leading role doing something that he was made to do. So I'm a bit disappointed by it, but I mean, you know, I always knew I would be. Even when I saw the trailer, I knew it was going to be disappointing. I wasn't holding out hope for it. It just further cements the fact that, sadly, the writing, I guess, just isn't there for people like De Niro and Pacino nowadays. So it's very sad, and it makes me sad. So I kind of want to forget about this film and this review, even though it's perfectly passable. You can go and watch it and enjoy it. But that's it, you watch it once and it was okay. Like I said, you don't hate it enough and you don't like it enough, or I didn't anyway. So I've forgotten about it, and probably after this I'll never talk about it again. Like a okay meal, I guess. It's like a spaghetti bolognese that was perfectly passable. But in a week's time, if someone said to you, "What did you have for dinner last Tuesday?" you say, "I don't know." And yeah, with this film, I don't know. It was no good. It was okay. Fuck this. Yeah. De Niro, sort it out. Let's get something sorted for next time, please. Play a mafia man. That's what I want to see. Play a mafia man with an actual attitude who doesn't fucking crack wise. And team up with Joe Pesci again, because that's the only way that you work.